The 10 Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au. Welcome to the Oz 10 Pin Lanes at Chirnside Park in Melbourne, Victoria for the running of the Sweps Melbourne 10 Pin Cup.
Hello and welcome to Oz 10 Pin in Chirnside Park, sunny Melbourne. We're here for the men's final of the 2011 Sweps Melbourne 10 Pin Cup. Our challenger, Michael Little, is going to take on our top seed, Jason Balmonte from Orange, New South Wales. On the chance that Jason is defeated, there will be a repercharge. So both bowlers, good luck and may the best bowler win.
Thank you, George, and welcome to all our viewers to this week's edition of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. My name's Michael Tran, good to be with you for another exciting match. We have a treat for you this week, folks. Jason Balmonte from New South Wales bowled a 231.2 scratch average. He is a PBA Tour titlist. For his opening shot, shreds the rack for 10 count. Lovely shot to open with.
Shreds the rack for a 10 count and... all that hand, all those revs, and he's still throwing a fairly straight angle. He takes on last week's semi-final winner, Michael Little. He's averaged 226.27 this week, has a career total of 23 perfect games. Been in this situation before. Let's see what happens.
Oh, good opening shot. If you've been watching, folks, the last couple of weeks, Michael has been playing around that dark marker on the outside, or just outside, and has had a lot of success carrying.
Unique style here from Jason Balmonte. Haven't seen him on the show for about 3 years since he won the South Pacific Classic. Two-handed technique. Wow. Well, lots of revs there, but it's interesting. He's using about the most aggressive ball available on the market, but he's not covering a lot of boards. I've never seen Jason use a ball this aggressive without throwing lots and lots of ball speed.
Well, gives testament to exactly how tough the condition is out there. But Jason, well known for his maximum amount of power and the speed that he throws the ball down. Like you said, Brenton not using that speed because he mustn't feel that it's an advantage.
His first three games of qualifying, he only shot something like 500 or 510 for his first three. And he was using a lot of speed, slowed down thereafter, and has just been blasting it ever since. Michael Little now. If you remember the finish to last week's match, he looked very scratchy indeed, most fortuitous to get through to the final. He started really strongly here.
Oh, he's flown out the gate. And that shot right there is the cleanest that I've probably seen him throw in the last 2 or 3 weeks. Jason Balmonte now automatically falls 10 behind. We'll see what he can do with his third attempt. Oh, very, very strong pocket hits. All three shots now, but ringing 10 pins for frame 2 and 3.
Yeah, it looks like his break point's just that hair late. It's probably only 3 to 5 feet, but it's just enough to get the ball going just slightly behind the head pin. Three pins going slightly back, six pins going around the 10. He needs to make a slight adjustment to his angle.
Good spare shot from Jason. To be playing on the professional PBA Tour, you really need to be on top of your game for your single pin spares, let alone any spare, for that fact. But he's very, very good with that two-handed style.
Miss a single pin on the Pro Tour, you're giving 20 pins away to the entire field, just about. Now, Michael Little, big opportunity here to jump out to a big early lead. Oh, whoa. That was ball speed.
Yes.
Nothing but ball speed. The previous couple of shots hit that same target, but that ball, softer ball speed, it broke 5 to 8 feet early through the beak, and he's paid full penalty. Remember last week he spared the Greek Church. I'm sure he's going to go with a fair bit of speed here. See if he can knock something. Actually, I'm quite surprised there. He sort of, that shot was almost a little bit defeatist, I thought. Most surprising.
You give Jason Belmonte an inch and he'd definitely take a mile on you. And look, I don't think he was terribly pleased with the way that ball reacted, but he'll be a little bit more careful, and I don't think he saw that one coming. Jason now taking a little bit of extra time. He knows he's got a big opportunity here.
I reckon he's going to jump all over this opportunity.
Oh, well, he hasn't missed the pocket yet. It's just a case of carry.
He has a 4-pin lead. Oh, just that little adjustment with the speed. Slightly earlier break point. No theatrics, no messengers, nothing. Just a flush hit. Perfect shot.
Michael Little now to respond. Oh, that's way outside.
Yep. And not getting the break that he got in the semi-final against Glenn Loader. Leaving just the 2-pin.
Probably come off the hand a little bit quick too, and after throwing the shot a little bit slower on the previous one, it was a case of over-adjustment, I would say. Single pin pickup. And remains there just the 4 pins behind.
It is, George.
Hi, after 4 frames, I'm here with Jason Belmonte. Strike, 9 spare strike. You're looking pretty comfortable out there. How's things?
Yeah, a couple of spares in the middle there. I'm quite happy with how I'm throwing it, so just got to make sure that I whisper in that ears, that bowling ball's ear to start striking.
Excellent. Well, I'm a big fan of doing that myself. Good luck for the rest of the match.
Last time on Ballopolis.
Meet me on lane one if you want to save your father and the earth.
I'm so glad you made it to my party. At first I thought you weren't coming, and I was like, ew, I don't like him anymore. And then I saw you and was like, yay, I like him again.
You don't mind if I warm up, do you, Lenny?
Look, we're going to need a strategy if you're going to defeat the Kingpin and save your dad.
No problem. I've got a foolproof plan that can't fail.
Great. Are you a good bowler?
No.
Brilliant. It can't fail.
Well, I believe I'm ready. Have you warmed up ever so tiny, Lane Kegler?
Not really.
Oh, well, please. Be my guest. Like any amount of practice could possibly help you, you little...
Pardon me?
Oh, nothing. Go right ahead. Of course, you couldn't beat me on the best day you ever had, you sniffling.
What?
Silly me. Just talking to myself. This ain't myself that's gonna win that sizable.
I'm sorry, are you talking to me?
Just bowl.
What are you doing?
Picking at the ball.
Not like that. Look, you place your hands around the ball like this, and you lift the ball with both hands. Then, and only then, you insert your fingers into the holes.
Like this.
Perfecto! Whoa, Chief. What are you doing now?
Setting.
Have you ever known red flashing lights and warning buzzers to be a good thing? See that big, bold line stretching across the lane? That's the foul line. Never, ever, ever, never, ever, never, ever cross it. Haven't you ever bowled before?
No! I thought we covered that in an earlier episode.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Proceed.
Come on, baby. Fred!
Wow. You stink, Lewis.
He's right, Lewis. You do kind of stink.
Tell me something I don't know.
President Grover Cleveland had a rubber jaw.
I think I'll go to the pro shop and purchase a towel to polish my sizable trophy.
Welcome back to the Oz 10 Pin Lanes at Chirnside Park in Victoria and the Sweps Melbourne 10 Pin Cup.
Hi, I'm here with Michael Little after four frames in, and Mick started with a double, but just one little blemish there after the third frame. Back on track now?
Yeah, hopefully, mate. Just got to get in back around the pocket. With that one, I just caught a little bit of it and just trying to roll the ball out there without really catching it too much. So just see how we go. Hopefully I can get back on track.
Yeah, mate. Well, it's still, you know, it's a four pin game yet. So, good luck for, you know, for the rest of the game.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you.
And welcome back to the final match for the men's 2011 Schweppes Melbourne 10 Pin Cup. We pick up proceedings at the top of frame five. Jason Belmonte holding a four pin lead. Oh, wow. Big surprise there. Yes, I thought there was supposed to be a lot of surface oil right there in the middle of the lane where Jason threw it.
Talking a little bit of a different bowler here, though. That just jumped. That surprised Belmo, because even he's had hold air in the middle of the lane there all week. And that one just took off.
Yeah, for the most part, Jason, for the last couple of frames, he's been throwing just inside.
Oh, heck. That frame was just a little bit, just a little bit dicey, that one. And nearly got the three pin out.
Yeah, he's been playing just inside that dark marker board, so it'll be interesting what tack he decides to go from there. Michael Little now, hopefully to stay clean with his game.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no.
And last week he was hitting that right lane really nicely. Now lost the right lane, hitting the left.
This one we call the big four. And, no guesses as to why. Takes out the two on the right-hand side, which is pretty much as good as you can do in this particular scenario. He picked up the Greek Church last week, if you were watching, viewers.
That was the most difficult spare in bowling. You see fewer big fours spared than just about anything else, except maybe the 5-7-10.
Just for your information, I believe the big four's only been spared four times in professional bowling. Gives you some sort of idea as to how often it's been picked up.
Yeah, doesn't happen very often, does it?
Jason, wow, hammering that pocket there. He's definitely corrected what he couldn't do on the left side.
Has that lane sorted. Only needs now to get himself sorted out on the left-hand lane. And Michael Little's going to be in trouble. He's already in trouble. He's 20 pins behind. Needs to get it happening now.
Back in the pocket, which is a good sign, but and leaving that 10-pin there. You watch the 6-pin here on the replay, folks. Not quite enough energy there.
Looked like a change in the roll pattern there. Looked like he stayed behind that one just a little bit more. A little bit less loft, a little more forward roll. Didn't get the job done, unfortunately.
Definitely is the higher percentage play on this particular lane pattern. Picking up the 10 pin.
Sticking slightly on the approach there, I think.
And at this point, he remains 20 pins behind. But that could go out to 30 if Belmonte gets up and throws a strike here.
Yeah, it's just a little subdued at the moment, kind of like they're waiting for something to happen.
Been a bit of a lackluster final at this point in time, hasn't it? I mean, Jason's just done enough. He's been clean.
He's hit the pocket five times out of six. Unusually low number of strikes for him, though. See what happens here.
Quite accustomed to see a few more from Belmonte, the calibre of bowler he is.
Snaps the 10 out.
Knows how much that meant. Two in a row. Double fist pump. And one would suggest one hand firmly on that sizable trophy.
That wasn't some type of a pun there, was it?
Oh, no, no. No, not at all.
I guess you would have said he had two hands on the trophy if that was the case.
Oh, well, he's only a frame or two away from having that near. But...
And Michael Little now, really, it's just all starting to unravel a bit for him. The good carry that he got last week, pretty much deserting him now.
So you one-handers out there could throw the plastic water bottle pun, but you wouldn't go there, would you?
No, I wouldn't.
No.
We'll leave that one well and surely alone.
That's absolutely, true. Absolutely. Yeah. Most important, folks, to stay hydrated when you're bowling. So
that jury's still out on that particular matter.
Oh, look, it will be for some time, but one would say Jason's put that well and truly behind him.
That he has. But what's really impressed me with Jason this week, he's made such a massive speed adjustment. I've never seen him throw the ball this slowly. Probably hasn't thrown it this slowly for best part of 10 or 15 years since he was a junior. It was just such a massive, massive change for him this week. Softening the ball speed like that. He did it so quickly and so instantly, and looks like he's been doing it all his life. And that's been the really impressive thing for Jason Belmonte this week.
And the lower ball speed there, resulting in another big four, and he could just about kiss his chances goodbye with that one.
That you can. That's, at the moment, the absolute best that Michael Little can shoot if he doesn't spare here. It'll be something in the low 180s. Jason Belmonte merely needs to show up in the 9th and 10th, and he'll be a winner. But if I know Jason, he'll be going all out to finish off in style.
Oh, there will be no holds barred for these last two frames for Jason Belmonte. Guarantee you that. Be right back.
Here with Jason Belmonte, 8th frame, sizable lead, working on a 3-bagger. Led the tournament for the entire week. Must be pretty good to be in this situation.
Yeah, it is. But, you know, Mick's one of my best mates out here, so it's always a little disappointing to see him not strike the way that I know he can. So, obviously, even though he's my best mate, I don't mind seeing him bend 122 in the 8th, and I'm a little more than him. But I have a feeling he's going to strike out and get this a little closer.
Okay, I'm not sure if he will, but we'll see. Hi, I'm here with Michael Little, 8 frames in. Mate, last game you had a fair bit of things go your way. This week, not so much.
No. 3 bad shots, 3 splits. Just terrible, mate. So.
Well, mate, finish it off like I know you can. Well done.
And for more information on the TV show, please visit our website, www.tenpinbowlingshow.com.au.
Top of the 9th now, Jason Belmonte with an almost insurmountable lead. Really only needs to show up for the 9th and 10th, throw some decent shots, just like that.
Well,
and we have a winner right there. Does not need to even turn up for the 10th. He's a winner. The balance of the line, something we haven't, that much balance from the line we haven't seen from Jason in the past. A product of the slower ball speed, rock solid at the line. And he's just throwing the ball so well. I can't get over. This is 4 or 5 kilometres an hour slower ball speed than he normally throws. And that much difference is just so hard to do under the gun. And he's just taken to it like a duck to water this week.
Yeah, look, it's an excellent point you make there, Brenton, because, I know myself as a two-handed bowler. It is very difficult to change the amount of speed you get on the ball. Generally, if you throw it a bit slower, it means you catch the ball more, which means the ball's going to hook more in the back end. Not so with Jason. He's been able to maintain his low ball speed and be able to put the same amount of revolutions on the ball every shot. It's been most impressive.
Watched his first block in this tournament. He was absolutely all at sea. Made a big, big adjustment and just hasn't looked back. And on a victory lap now, this is possibly the best bowl Australia's ever produced. And there's White. Knows he's a winner now and just ball's a blur revving in the back end of the lane there. That's just...
That vision right there is incredible, isn't it? Just the amount of roll and revolutions that that the ball takes on its way to that 1-3 pocket is just incredible. And that's why he's Australia's best.
You don't get Rookie of the Year and become a PBA titleist by not knowing what you're doing. And he's putting the exclamation mark on it now. Really is.
Very, very happy with himself there. He's... Oh, look, here we go, party time.
Oh, why not?
Pulls out the plastic ball. Straight down the middle. Eats the pocket alive with another 10. He's just put on a clinic today. A 249. Very, very impressive. And takes out the 2011 Schweppes Melbourne Tenpin Cup in style. Well, 9 strikes out of 12. He's been most impressive. Very, very clean. And I think throughout that whole game, I only missed the pocket once.
The 11 pocket hits out of 12 in a final under the gun. It's very, very impressive. And people just don't realise how tough these lanes played all week, especially in this part of the house. This was the lower scoring part of the house, if anything. You know, most of the higher scores were down the higher end of the house in the main section. This section of the house did score a little bit lower.
Just quickly on that point, do you mind explaining why that was the case?
This part of the house, if anything, there just seemed to be just a hair less margin for error.
Is it more atmospheric, where one side of the house was a little bit warmer to the rest and just means the lanes were a little bit easier to play?
It's entirely possible. Couldn't say for sure. Oh, a 10-pin there to finish for Michael Little. Defeated by Jason Belmonte, 249 to 161.
And look, a second place finish for Michael Little. He'll take it away with him, he'll be happy with that. But Jason Belmonte, he was the victor by a fair margin.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the completion of the stepladder finals for the men's 2011 Schweppes Melbourne Cup. In third place from New South Wales, Glenn Loader. In second place from Newcastle, New South Wales, Michael Little. And the champion for the 2011 Schweppes Men's Melbourne Cup from New South Wales, Orange, and via the USA on the Pro Tour, Jason Belmonte. And to say a few words, the State Accounts Manager for Schweppes in Victoria, Mr. Brenton Standen.
Thanks, Brenton. Thanks very much. Schweppes Australia have really enjoyed our association with the Oz 10-pin bowling group and the Schweppes Melbourne 10-pin cup. And we look forward to doing it all again next year. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Brenton. And that's it for the 10-pin bowling show for this week. We'll see you with another exciting match next week. Thank you for viewing.
The 10-pin bowling show was proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.